Okay. Welcome to our Monday night chat. My name is Lisa Robertson, and of course, this is my Facebook page. So every Monday night, we like to do a little live chat, live video streaming, whatever you want to call it, and talk about what's coming up for this next week. Obviously, this is a very light week because we're going into Christmas, so we're going to talk about what's coming up this week. David Markstein is going to be joining me. I always think that jewelry is something that, you know, you love any time of the year. We have some beautiful, beautiful jewelry coming up. But one of the things I wanted to address, because of the fact that it's definitely caused some issues for us around the holiday, we have been having some major issues with our customer care platform. We are getting them resolved. We really made a lot of progress on that today, and then we have a team working on it again tomorrow, so we do apologize. I know it's the worst time of the year to have issues with your customer care platform, and we are absolutely working on it. So I know a lot of you started getting responses today because we were finally able to get things back to where they should be, and we will definitely be on top of that going forward, and we do apologize greatly, especially, of course, during the holiday. So we have some beautiful things to look at tonight. I don't think we're gonna need an hour, but I do wanna tell you that we're gonna have a little hello from our friend Antoinella a little bit later on. She's not gonna be here person, but we're gonna talk to her. So don't go away, because Antoinella's coming up and we all absolutely adore her. So I hope everyone's having a wonderful, wonderful holiday. I don't understand how we started decorating for Christmas here at the beginning of October, and I feel like it just sprang up and I don't even have time to get ready for it, but it's just one of those things. So David Markstein is going to be joining us with some of the jewelry, actually all the jewelry, coming up this week. And it is a lighter week. You know, now we're kind of in the time period where you're getting a little something for yourself, shopping for something to look forward to. I like shopping now because then you have something to look forward to in the new year. Yeah. Now, I'm going to have this new piece of jewelry. It's going to be so great.
I think you said it. Jewelry's great. Any time of year. That's what I say.
Jewelry is always great. David Markstein, who of course is in charge of all of our jewelry. David was the lead jewelry buyer at QVC for over 20 years. He is someone who's been in the industry for a long time. He started, you know, as a child. And
I was a child.
Child labor laws apply, but you know, he was fine. And he really does bring us gorgeous pieces from all over the world. And we wanted to bring you some really, really beautiful pieces in this week to kind of shop for yourself and have something to look forward to and all the craziness. I think around the holidays, I'm going to stop talking a second, I swear. But you're doing a million things for a million people because you want to make it good for everyone. And then you just don't take care of yourself.
Absolutely.
So David has some really pretty pieces. Yeah, some nice pieces. To take care of yourself.
We say jewelry from around the world tonight, like we always do, but it's great.
Always good.
Good pieces.
Always good. So at noon today, by the way, we started out with a couple of pieces that were absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. Let me see if I have that. What did I do with the black lid of that box?
Oh. Yeah,
Wait for it.
Here it is.
It's black, so it's hard to see if it's down there in the shadows. Oh, good. Yeah, I think this worked really well. Hold on. Okay, so these two pieces we started out with at noon today, and I think these can be kind of nice with this one.
Yeah.
Kind of a little bit of a shadow box effect.
Yeah, but get in there now, we'll see.
These are stunning, and it was so interesting because Kate was looking at these today, and she thought they were natural diamonds.
Can't. Are those real diamonds? She's talking like, no, they're not.
So the work on these is so delicate that it really, really looks like natural diamonds. They're going to be cubic zirconia. We have the earrings and we have this beautiful, beautiful bracelet. And oh my gosh, is this gorgeous. So when you're looking at this, look how fine it is. Isn't that amazing?
And I love the clasp too, because they did the clasp in a very easy way where it just clicks into place, but then it's seamless. So you don't see the clasp once it's on. In fact, sometimes it's like, where's the clasp? I lost it. So it's really nice that it just kind of goes around and you really don't have that stoppage of a clasp in this case.
Yeah, it's
but
very, very smooth.
I mean, we're talking about status links a lot, and I like the idea of taking a curb, which can be somewhat traditional, and really make an upscale look to it by making this micro pave all over every link. A lot of labor, all done by hand, but it's a beautiful combination when you combine this with the earrings that were also today. So the combination of the earrings, which are the exact same look as that bracelet, choice of yellow or white, 18 karat gold over sterling silver, and that is CZ, as Lisa said.
I just wanted to show it to you with the watch.
because I think it's so gorgeous.
I think it's a great layering piece. I think this is the type of scale that you'd find in very high end stores, and it's that look of 18 karat gold and diamonds, and it really is what's hot. One of the things that I'm seeing in all the magazines are these status curbs and different links, like marine links and all of these type of links that they wear together. And you know, it's something that's really taken on a life of its own. And I always like to say that, you know, when we've been in the industry this long, you could see this trend's coming. And I think this is a trend that we've seen now for a while, but you're gonna see this taking off in a more explosive way in the new year. It's something that I'm hearing about, that different status links, different looks like this, and we're always early to the party on it.
Yeah, but I love the fact that the scale really is so fine.
Yeah.
You know, it is exactly the scale that you would find in diamonds and 18 karat gold. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful with your other bracelets. It's gorgeous next to a watch. It is timeless. It's not a trend or a fad. You know, they say, you know, I mean, you know the phrase, every dog has its day. Well, when it comes to jewelry, every classic has its day. So even though this is so classic that it will never go out of style, it still happens to be one of the biggest trends right now. And I absolutely love that, because then I know that even when I'm buying something that happens to be in, it's still always going to be in.
Yes.
You know,
and
just gorgeous.
You're right. This is a great layering piece with the watch on its own, but it does work really well with all different looks. I like to say that this is one of those eclectic looks that you could put together and just mix and match and be yourself. And you know, kind of just design the way you like to design your look. So,
one of the things I want to mention about the earrings is that the earring backs are a little unusual.
Actually, they were explaining those to me. I'm like, well, what are these? Because they're actually sterling silver and this kind of material. It's a rubberized material, but they slide in so easily.
Oh my gosh,
and
I love
stay.
Them.
They're really ingenious.
I got to tell you, when I first looked at them, I thought these are odd, and then when I actually tried them, I thought these are so nice. I mean, you're not hurting your ear, you're not pushing, you're not forcing it, it's not rough, it's not, these are beautiful, and they hold beautifully.
Well. They actually have a sterling silver disc in the middle of them, which keeps them in place and really makes them strong.
But it's gotta be kind of like a silicone.
Yeah, silicone.
On the front and back.
It's a silicone.
It holds in place beautifully, it's absolutely gorgeous. It's one of those things that is so stunning. I'm telling you, when you wear these earrings, they're so comfortable and they stay in place so well. Yeah. I love them in the yellow and the white, and they really do look like diamond earrings. They look like, wow, I can't believe you actually went out and bought diamond earrings.
It does look like that. I'm very pleased how these came out. We're getting these from manufacturers who really design in diamonds.
Mm-hmm.
And they design in gold only, and they seem to help us making some stuff for us more affordable in sterling silver, but still using the 18 karat gold plating over the sterling and the rhodium. So it's really, it's a nice combination.
So that is not gonna stay. I just wanted to put this on one of my ears just to show you how they
look. We've done a lot of these curb looking type earrings over the years, and they're always very popular because I think they're very easy to wear. I think they're not like so overpowering. They're lightweight, and they just look like you're not trying too hard.
Isn't that nice? So look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
It just looks like you spent a lot of money.
Yeah.
And went somewhere very special to get that.
I love those. And they're very comfortable.
Yeah.
You know, they're really beautiful on. They're not too heavy. They're not bulky. They just have this delicate feel to them, which I absolutely love. Obviously, this top has chain in it, and then this has chain in it, so it's kind of that a status chain is in when it's on the top and it's in the earrings.
Absolutely, definitely. Yeah. So it's great.
Gorgeous. So that's what started at noon today. They have been very, very popular.
A lot of other exciting things coming up.
And I know that this one's white, but I'm gonna put it on just so I have two earrings in my ear.
Yeah.
Because right now I only have one. So I do love the back of this. I have to say, this backing.
You put them on and you don't feel like, oh, are they on?
They feel
secure.
Fabulous. They stay in place. So good. If I could get it in the pierce of my ear, that's always helpful. How long have I had my ears pierced? I think it was my first day. All right, so those were starting at noon today. And I do, again, I love that those are going to be those classic status pieces that you love and you always love to wear, and they never go out of style. You know, because sometimes you can buy something and then a year later you're thinking, oh my gosh, why did I buy that? That's so, the 80s were an excellent example of that. The 80s were an excellent example of really bad decisions for an entire decade. I mean, the shoulder pads, the hair,
but you got
everything about it. Oh my gosh, it was really fun because we all looked really bad together at the same time. And it gave us a lot to laugh about later. But I love that this is something you're never gonna look back at that on, you know, it's always gonna be stunning. Yep. So love this. All right, where do you wanna go next?
Let's do the ring because that's coming up.
Yes, the ring is coming up.
And I kind of like it with the bracelet.
I did too. So the ring, why will that not stay? I'm just gonna give up on that. It's not gonna stay. The ring is beautiful. The ring is a beautiful highway style ring. And that means that it almost looks like there's a dimensional. Do you see how dimensional it is?
Yeah.
With the loops going in different directions. Really beautifully done. Again, the stonework on this is phenomenal.
Yeah, and the highway design, which has been popular for many, many years, got its name obviously because it looks like those causeways that you would drive over and under and all that. But it became this iconic symbol in jewelry because it showed dimension. It showed workmanship and craftsmanship, and it shows how difficult it is to design those pave bands. Let's call them each a separate band. It looks like all these different rings that you kind of put together as one. It has some height to it. It has a bold statement piece, I think, and it has some weight to it too, which I love too.
Isn't that gorgeous? I love it on a middle finger. I love it on a ring finger.
Show the side profile, like right, yeah, like that. You could see if Sam can get in there, how you see there's a little open space between there, and that's what's so nice about it. Like, it's not a lot of open space, but you could see it's just taking on a life of its own as each band goes under, over, and I think that's what's so special about it.
7 or 8 bands. I don't know. They just keep going. They're just beautiful.
And all the stones pave beautifully together.
They're gorgeous.
It really is an amazing work of art.
Wow. And again, it's just beautiful. It's never bulky. It's really delicate. Yeah. The stonework is beautiful. I'll just leave that on. Really, really gorgeous. Yeah. Always stunning. And it is one of those really classic pieces, once again. So a highway ring is as classic as a beautiful status link chain. Never goes out of style. And when it's done this beautifully, it's always something you're going to love to wear. So again, the earrings, the bracelet, the ring, these are all things that you're going to wear with jeans one way, you're going to dress up another way, you know, whatever you want to do, wherever you're going, they're going to be great on those. Yeah. Love those.
I agree.
All right, what do you want to talk about next?
Let's go to Italy. Let's go to Italy with these. I think these are so wonderful.
Yeah.
One thing I love about this is obviously it's a layering look all together, but I love the sheen of this diamond cutting. It just looks so high end.
This is beautiful. And I'm not sure that we're gonna be able to do it justice with the camera and the lighting and everything else. In person, this has this velvety, I don't know, little like a velvety sparkle to it. So it's not too shiny and it's not too matte. It's that Goldilocks, that perfect in between, that really rich, that beautiful texture that you associate with some of Italy's highest end gold factories. One of them starts with a B.
Yeah.
Ends with an I.
Yes.
And it's not Botticelli.
Ha. Nope. So. I know what it is. Of course. But I do like the fact that this is kind of taking that paperclip look too, but it's not like screaming the paperclip look. It's those elongated links that are connected together. And if you show the back of it, Lisa, and turn it around, I just want them to see how it's connected, that it is one chain in the back, and then that comes to three in the front that are all graduated, which I think is beautiful. So it's doing all the work for you.
Right.
My whole life in jewelry, I've learned from the customers that they sometimes like us to do the work for them.
Yeah.
Make it so the way the designer would have wanted it to be.
Right.
So you don't have to figure out, what do I do?
That way so I don't have to worry about it.
And I think they're spaced perfectly together. I do love the fact that we're doing this in yellow, white, rose, and tricolor, which I think is so stunning. I'm so happy we added that to the addition of
Right, so this is how it comes. This is tricolor, one of each, yellow, white, rose. Here it is all white, here it is all rose. We just made this one a little shorter so you could see them, but they're all the same length. Here it is in all yellow. But how beautiful is that?
Yeah.
You know, it's so gorgeous. It just drapes down your neck. It's really, really elegant. Again, that could be with the simple button-down top. That could be with the beautiful blouse at the office. Yeah. That can be, you know, over something that's kind of a higher crew neck, so you really see it on the fabric. That can be against skin. That can be any way you want it to be. Yeah.
I still love when the Italians do metal without stone sometimes, because this is what we originally always saw in Italy. It was always about the metal. And it was about every factory had their own texture. Mm-hmm. And they were so proud of it. You'd walk in and say, here's our new texture, and we've applied it to this necklace and this ring, and this is what this factory specializes in. The thousands of factories there used to be in Italy, not as many anymore, but they still specialize in certain things that they're great at. And this one is specializing in the special sheen of a texture. I don't even know how to really describe it, but it's a diamond cut, but it's just beautiful. When you see this in person, you're gonna absolutely love it.
So these are the kinds of pieces that kind of look like a whole wardrobe. Mm-hmm. And I also think this is the kind of piece that you would love to have. Mm-hmm. Somebody else probably wouldn't think of to get for you. It is gonna be really, really gorgeous. It's not your average piece. It's something that is extra special. Yep. And I cannot wait for you to try this on.
Yeah.
And see it. When you see it on, it is so beautiful. Oh my gosh. You are never gonna wanna take it off. Trust me when I tell you, it is stunning. And this is what the Italians do best. Yep. The Italians do metal.
Yeah.
They do textures, they do metal. This is what they do best. Status links, hello Italy. This is what they are known for. If you go and buy a piece of fine jewelry in Italy, you're probably gonna be looking at all metal and you're probably gonna be looking at status link. And you're definitely gonna notice the Italians do texture, nobody else does.
Nobody else does.
So everybody else, Italy sets the tone.
Yeah.
And everyone else tries to copy it for less.
Absolutely. No one can knock the Italians off with the looks that they do, because they have special machinery that is, and most of it's all done by hand, but the way they create these textures are just it's like a top secret. You walk in there and they don't want to show you how it
comes. They are very secretive about it. It's very, very funny. Yeah, they'll design new tools and new things to give a texture they want anyone to know. It's very, I love that. So this is Italian. Yeah. It's going to be a triple strand. It drapes beautifully. All yellow, all white, all rose, or tricolor, whichever you prefer. Absolutely, absolutely
gorgeous. Let me get this out of the
way, please. Okay.
And then do you want to stay in Italy for these?
I think
those are nice. I'll let you put those in front. Just as long as we're in Italy, let's stay in that country for a little.
All right, so I love these earrings. These are gonna be that simple earring that you love to wear and you wear all the time. I think we have two of the same here.
Well, it's two sizes.
Oh, that's why.
Two sizes.
I was like, wait a minute.
I know they're very subtle, but one of them is a little bit longer than the other. And I love the fact that these are linear bar earrings. And they're a little bit more elongated than the traditional bar. And what's also special is it's made of rectangular. It's a rectangular shape. Mm-hmm. So why I love that, and I've always explained it, is when you have rectangular, it's much more laborious than doing round, but because it hits the light from all different angles. So you have four different angles versus the round, which only kind of hits the light from different angles, but not the same as these sharp points that you have from this type of tubing. And it's just beautiful. I mean, it's really stunning. You see it even as the movement is great.
Mm, gorgeous.
The light's hitting it as it moves. And I even had trouble photographing these because the light was so powerful on them that it was like, oh my God, it's showing all different
little mirrors.
Mirrors on it. So it's just a beautiful look. And we decided, you know, why not do one kind of for everybody. Mm-hmm. And then one more for the people who want to step out a little bit, which I love. I love that, you know, they look so fabulous on. And you look like, when you're wearing these, you look Italian. You look like I went to Italy, I picked these up, I brought them back, and I got them from this little boutique in Ponte Vecchio. As I walking,
right.
I found some store, and I picked these up in 18 karat gold, and they don't have to know that it's actually 18 karat gold over sterling.
Right. Well, you know what's interesting is I honestly wish that I could open a store with art jewelry in Italy.
Oh my God, I always thought of that.
Because I have to tell you, when you go there, what happens is I feel like there's just not the in-between.
Yeah.
You know, there's the super expensive that's all gold, and these days with the price of gold, oh my gosh, is that, you know, that's prohibitive.
Yeah.
And then there's just play.
Yeah.
You know, there's not that in-between, and I feel like we do the Italian jewelry that is the in-between. I mean, we do the Italian jewelry that looks like gold, but it doesn't cost like gold.
Those are like mirrors coming down.
Aren't they amazing?
I love them. Let's see if Sam can get close up on that, because
they
look just stunning.
Aren't those gorgeous? Yeah.
And I'd like to say that I do not think these are only dress up. I think these are anytime, put a pair of jeans on. I think you can wear these just anywhere. They look fabulous. They look like you have purpose. You're very confident, very clean. I just love that. That's what I love. I love the clean look of these. That's the word I'm looking for.
But yeah, you could definitely, you know, put your hair back in a ponytail, put these on, really, really elegant, really finished. Yeah. Put it on with a leather jacket, very cool, very edgy. You know, there's just a lot of different ways to wear it, but they are, they're really pretty. They're simple, they're clean, they're cool, they're very fresh. Just a strong look, but still a feminine look, and I think that's sometimes not the easiest thing to find when it comes to jewelry. But I love the fact that we have it in the yellow. Yeah. I love the fact that we have it in the white. I love the fact that we have it in the rose. I got to tell you, I think you're going to get those earrings home and wear them all the time.
Yeah,
like that's going to be your new favorite.
I agree. Yeah. Earrings are a category that I love so much because I think a woman can never have too many pair of earrings. I always say that. And you want to have different looks in your wardrobe, so you want to wear a hoop sometimes, and you want to wear something a little sparkly with stones in it, but this is something that's very linear, clean, that's all metal. I love that.
So those are also coming up this week. They're going to be perfect for a little treat for you, you know, before the holidays.
Do you want to go with some gemstone now? Let's make out the gemstones. I'll just bring these over here so you can talk
about this is, I think I forgot to put the back on that one.
That's okay.
This ring is amazing. So I wanted to talk about this ring first of all. David, this ring is going to be apatite.
Yes.
In the center.
And in case people don't know, blue apatite is an exotic stone, very difficult to mine. And if you do mine it, you often don't get good quality. This is one of the stones that you do, they call it AAA quality. So when I'm buying this, I will always ask that question, what kind of apatite am I buying? Is it AA, single A, or AAA? And this is AAA quality, and you know, you pay more for that. But I think it was the only way to do this ring was to put the best of that apatite in there. And this is 1.8 carats, so it's a nice stone in the center. But I love the juxtaposition of the color here. I like the blue with the black. Don't you think that's kind of interesting?
Yeah, it's very cool.
And like, there's like
the black stones are?
Are black spinel.
Okay.
Black spinel.
So you have this beautiful black spinel around.
All micropavied.
Look how gorgeous this is. Isn't that beautiful? One of the things I like is that it curves over the finger. So it's really, really comfortable. It doesn't come up too high off the finger, so it doesn't get in the way. Yeah. But it's a big, big look from the front, which is stunning. Love that.
And in case you're wondering, blue apatite looks different than blue topaz. It definitely has a more saturated color to it. Almost like a deeper blue, I think, almost.
And a hint of green.
A hint of green in there.
Hint of green and blue. Yeah, really, really beautiful. It's definitely a different color. It is an exotic stone. It's absolutely, absolutely beautiful. And it is one of those stones that is going to get you so many compliments. Yep. Guaranteed, you cannot wear this ring without somebody saying, oh my gosh, that's amazing. Where'd you get it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, love that. And I do love it on a middle finger.
Yeah, it looks good on
I think it's a great middle finger.
It's a good middle finger ring. Yeah.
I can't wear a seven on this hand on middle fingers. I have to wear this hand on middle finger. But yeah, it's a really, really great, there you go, middle finger.
And you're right, it doesn't get in the way when you wear that because all the design is on the top, but curves
gorgeous?
So that it's very easy to wear and not.
Love.
Yes.
So speaking of gemstones, we also have this beautiful, beautiful earring, and we have this in a variety of stones. So what are the stones on this one?
So we have amethyst.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right over here.
Amethyst, blue topaz.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That is, what's it called?
Chalcedony.
Chalcedony, thank you. This is pink quartz.
Ah,
and then that's citrine.
Beautiful. It's a really deep citrine, by the way.
And that's opalite, which we used to carry a lot, and it was so popular, and we're doing it back again, which is nice.
Oh my gosh.
And so what's so fascinating about this is, you know, sometimes it's hard to cut gemstones in different shapes, but they did a special cut here. They're calling it a laser cut stone, and it's suspended from the bottom. This is from Bali. We talk about Bali because everything's done by hand. They do everything in a certain way, a look to it. But they've taken their style, and they've done something very different with these earrings. They're more elongated, they come down, and they hold, like these fingers that are holding this stone in place.
Yeah.
And that is so difficult to do, because when you're only holding that stone by four different ridges or edges, that stone has to be perfect. There's no flaws in that stone, or you will notice it. So they're taking a chance with this, but it looks beautiful.
It's really, really stunning, I have to say. And I think that it almost looks very art Art Nouveau,
yeah, Art
in a
Nouveau,
way, because
yeah.
it has some of the curve in there. It looks a little like the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah.
We were saying that today.
Yes.
It's like the Eiffel Tower. So I think that it just has a lot of different looks to it, but it's absolutely beautiful. And it has just that little bit of sparkle and kind of texture going down the earring.
Yeah.
And then that beautiful stone below. This is one that everybody in the office was talking about.
Yeah.
It's really different, really cool. And if you prefer silver not plated in rhodium,
yeah.
which is very difficult to find these days, the handmade silver from Bali is one of
yes.
the few places where they are making sterling silver jewelry and not plating it
yep.
In rhodium. So
and one of the things they do on their silver, you can see there's little hints of a design on all the silver. It's like the mm-hmm. scroll work and things like that, which I love so much.
Gorgeous.
So I like all the colors we're offering. Think about this, the gamut of colors that you have. So you really get to pick your choice, what you like, whether you're thinking of summer, winter, whatever
yeah.
you want.
Or a birthstone,
yeah.
or just a color you love, or what you
yeah.
like to wear, whatever it happens to be. So these are all absolutely gorgeous, all handmade in Bali, and those are also
yeah.
coming up
yep.
this week.
Okay, and then we're gonna go back to Italy and stay in Italy for the rest of the night.
Okay, so this is an absolutely beautiful, beautiful cameo.
This.
The cameo on this is astounding. The quality of the carving on this cameo is a quality I have not seen in a long time. Look at how delicate every single flower, every lock of her hair, every curl, everything about this is flawless and delicate
yeah.
and intricate and perfect and amazing.
And by comparison, which you at home really can't quite understand, is we see a lot of cameos that are not like this.
Mm-hmm.
And the difference is, like, when we're looking at them, we comment, like, you can't see the hair like that. It's just all kind of muddy.
But it almost looks not finished.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of cameos look not finished. You know, they're kind of a rougher look.
And this is because the artists are just not as good as other artists. Some
mm-hmm.
artists can really get in there. And it says, remember, they're doing this on a conch shell. This is all done on a shell. But what I love about this so much is we've surrounded it by these beautiful garnet gemstones,
mm-hmm.
over 4 carats of garnet in this ring. And the border of it is beautiful. And it comes on this beautiful rope chain, which I think is
Isn't
so perfect
stunning?
For this. I think the rope chain fits, everything fits. Look at the size of that bale. Look at the back of this. I mean, it's just really beautiful combination. And this really does look like you went to Italy and bought something, because I just think that
you could not get more Italian. It looks like your last name should be Lex Forza, one of the
yeah.
historic paintings of that. You know?
You're talking about Vicenza and you go to the shows. It wouldn't be a show if you didn't find your one cameo that you wanted to bring back and
mm-hmm.
show off. And so this is something that I think is beautiful.
Well, you know, it's interesting because we went to Italy in September with some of our customers and our friends. We had the best time.
Yeah.
And obviously, I've been to Italy a lot of times.
Mm-hmm.
And I already have a lot
yeah.
of things from Italy.
Yeah.
What's the one piece I bought this time? Cameo.
Did you good.
You know, it's just, there's something about it that is so Italian and so beautiful. And this one is just exquisite. I mean, it is exquisite. It is not what you find anywhere. It looks like 18 karat gold. It looks like you were on Madison Avenue or the Ponte Vecchio or the Via Condotte in Rome, where you are right down from the Spanish Steps. And then there's that main road and it's all high-end couture. This is what it looks like. It looks
yeah.
like you saved for a year and spend it all
yeah.
on one piece. So,
yeah, I think it's beautiful.
Beautiful.
I love
yeah.
the combination again. We don't often do this with gemstones on the border. Sometimes we struggle, like, we like the cameo, but what are you gonna do on the border? Well, this nails everything. It just comes together so beautifully here.
I love that. So that is also coming up
okay.
this week, and I think that is a very, very special piece.
So we have one more piece left.
Okay. Now this is going to be something that is very near and dear to my heart. And I'm gonna get her on the phone in a
okay.
second, but Antonella Nestor, who I love more than life itself. And one of the things that I love about Antonella is I can be having the worst day ever. She's having a worse day than I am, and she
Sorry,
still cheers
Antonella.
Me up.
Just, I assume
yeah.
everybody out there knows who Antonella is, but just in case they don't.
Antonella Nestor is a good friend of mine who was a host on QVC for many, many years.
My friend too.
Yes, and definitely. And she and I both share our love of jewelry. And I adore her. I always loved working with her. She has been so kind and had me over to her house for Thanksgiving with their family when I, you know, didn't have anywhere to go because I was working.
Yeah.
And just amazing. So she is no longer there. She and her husband have had huge changes in their life. And through everything they've been going through, she continues to be the most inspiring, uplifting person I know.
It is amazing.
I just, I am... absolutely, absolutely incredulous. And life has really thrown her and her family some major curveballs, and she is in better spirits than people I know who have everything.
Resilient.
I am astounded. And this is something that was inspired by her. So we're gonna get her on the phone. Yep. Hold on just a second. I obviously talked to her about this, so she knows I'm calling.
It is really a special piece. And you know, I remember Lisa reaching out to Antonella, like, what is near and dear to your heart? Do you have something that you think would represent who you are? And this was that piece that we took to Italy and we designed with her. And we went back and forth and we said, no, we don't want this, we want this. And Antonella told us who she liked.
So I'm gonna go ahead and just hide those back there. Yep. So they're out of the way. Hold on just a second.
Well, she doesn't pick up.
Right.
Hey, girl.
Hey, you're on speakerphone.
Don't curse me out, Antonella. Not now.
I know. I was like, that's really iffy. Should I have her on speakerphone when she answers?
Maybe you should hold it first.
Right. Okay. So.
You're rolling the dice if you do that.
So I hope everybody can hear Antonella. She's on my phone.
Why don't you give that to Sam to hold, because she's right underneath
there. There you go. Perfect. Thank you, Sam. Closer to the microphone. So make sure the bottom kind of aims up at the mic. Perfect. Yes. Sam is now doing her Statue of Liberty imitation and doing a beautiful job.
Let us know if they're not hearing Antonella, if whilst we're doing this.
Okay. So Antonella, who is one of the people I love most in this world. Hi, honey.
Hi.
So Antonella, I was reaching out to Antonella to say, you know, what piece of jewelry, because I wanted to do something with her in mind. Really inspired by her and how amazingly resilient she is, said, you know, what would be near and dear to your heart? And so Antonella, you sent us a picture of a necklace that you have worn for many, many years. And can you tell us what the necklace is, and then we'll look at it here.
Oh, I'm sorry, did you say the last part one time?
Okay, can you explain to everyone what the necklace is that you sent us the picture of, and then we did one for you?
Okay, I know. Yeah, you make me want to break down and cry. The necklace, well, everyone knows you and I love jewelry, but when you add meaning to a piece of jewelry, it just elevates and intensifies the affinity that I have for the piece. So this piece is something I hold on to for dear life. It symbolizes so many things on so many different levels. It symbolizes hope because it is the symbol of hope. So unless you don't know that, it's an anchor. It's also the name of my daughter. And Lord knows I have needed to carry a lot of hope around with me this past year, as a lot of people have had to, with COVID, with jobs, with all kinds of things. We have to hold on to hope. And sometimes for me, I'm a very visual person, and so I need to see it, I need to hold it, I need to touch it, and I need to feel it. And so it symbolizes hope on two different levels, my daughter's name and the emotion. It has a rope on it, and that stands for strength. And again, to hang on. It has a cross on it, which for me symbolizes faith. And it's something that I could not have gone through a lot of things in my life, not just the last year, but a lot of things in my life without that faith. And I also see the crossbars as the streaming lights on our sailboat, and they give off light and guidance. So that anchor is a way to anchor myself, stay balanced, remember who you are, have hope, have faith, be strong, hang on, keep your inner light going, let it shine, and share it with others. So this piece is so much wrapped up in one little piece of jewelry.
Well,
and every time I touch it, every time I see it, every time I feel it, to remind myself, remember who you are. Don't lose your way. Stay balanced. Stay strong. Keep the faith. Have hope for anything and everything in my life. So it's just a very big catch-all piece, if you want to say.
Well, I have to say that one of the things that I hear everyone saying about Antonella, me included, is that you want to hold that for a second, Sam? You got it? I'm going to say, poor Sam is going to have, her arm's going to fall off. Is that one of the things I always hear everyone say about Antonella, and I always say it too, is that she's very inspiring. And that, you know, everybody wishes, oh my gosh, I wish I could just have her energy. Why can't I have her energy? And so for me, I love this because I do think that it's a way of giving that energy, of inspiring people. It's everyone's little piece of inspiration. It's something that can motivate people and comfort people and make them feel strong and give them inspiration and make them not feel alone. And all those things that I think I feel when I talk to Antonella. But, you know, we can't all call Antonella on the phone. So what we have is a necklace, which will make you think of, here you go, Sam, I just want to give your arm a break, which can kind of give you that peace and that reminder and take you back to that place. So this is something that we're going to have made for you. This is going to be an advance order, and it's going to be available for just a few days this week. It is going to be a longer delivery time because of some things going on with this factory in Italy, so definitely, you know, pay attention to the page on that one. But I wanted something that would be a source of inspiration for everyone at this time. I think that number one, that's important, and number two, the proceeds are going to go to really help with everything that Antonella and her family have been going through this year. And so I thought this is a win-win because everyone can use inspiration and hope. Everyone wants to have that one thing in their life that they can kind of touch that makes them feel better. And obviously it helps someone that I care for dearly at the same time.
And I didn't tell you this, but our friends in Italy, Antonella, and you know who they are, when they heard this was for you,
David, honey, you're right in front of the camera, just to let you know.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. When they heard this was for you, Antonella, they said, we're going to work at cost. We're not making money on this. So normally, I'm going to say the price. Normally, this would be $79. This is $59.
Oh, my gosh.
And so they want to help in any way they can.
Oh, my gosh.
I think it's just a statement to Antonella, who is so well known in Italy, not just at QVC, not just around her friends. And I think that's just something really special, and I love the design, Antonella. Can you say a little bit more about why it's a combination of cross and an anchor? It's I've never seen that before in my life. So,
it's such a beautiful. First off, can I just say thank you to Lisa, David? I know who you're talking about in Italy too. Very, very charming, wonderful family, and thank you to your Facebook friends there and the folks that you have there online. It is with a big heart that you all do this, and it touches me tremendously on so many levels, but mostly in what Lisa said, that to be able to have a lot of people have something to hold on to and to feel the meaning that this piece has given me. The whole look of this, and it's three-dimensional. So in other words, and of course, leave it to the Italians to do it that way, where it's really a piece of art and not just a piece of jewelry. But the back is fully finished. It is 3D. It's real. It's something to hold on to. It is an anchor. It is a cross. It is strengthened ropes. It is faith. It is hope. It is all the things I think that so many of us need. I know I did. And I'm sorry, David, what was your question?
I thought the design was so interesting because you've taken two symbols, the cross and the anchor, and you've come up with a way of combining them into one pendant. And I think it's a beautiful combination. And I don't, you know, it doesn't scream cross. It doesn't scream anchor. It's the combination of those two that really makes this design interesting.
Right. It's this beautiful twist of gold or silver or precious metal, but this shine, this intrigue. There's this dimension that you splash into with the twist of the rope. You see the curve coming up with the anchor support. And then you have the sleekness, that almost stiletto look of the cross. So there's all of this, if I could say, eye candy to it that pulls you in. but doesn't tell your eye exactly what you're looking at right away. So it's almost a mystery till you come in, you hold it, you feel it, you touch it, and then you start to be able to put it all together for what it is and what it means to you. So it's an intense piece without being in your face. Mm-hmm. It is a clear message without screaming at you.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it has so much in the way that it turns, twists, the way you look at it, the way you feel it. It has a lot. It's hard for me to ever take it off.
Well, I am so excited that we were finally able to get this together. I love that it is something that I think is just like one of those symbols that everyone loves to wear. And not, it doesn't even, it, you know, it's almost like sometimes you'll wear a cross even underneath your shirt where no one sees it because it really is
for
you.
Yeah.
And that's what I think this is. You know, this is something you can wear that other people see. This is something you can wear that nobody else sees. But however you wear it, it is a very special piece. It has a lot of very special meanings. I think it's something that has meaning for so many different people coming from so many different backgrounds and looking at it in so many different ways. And I love the fact that it's something that I associate with Antonella.
Yeah.
And I do, of course, I just find her, you, Antonella, to be someone who is one of the most inspiring people I've ever known. And I know that you have been on a journey for the last year. And you just, like, you're still up, you're still positive and optimistic and hopeful and fun. And, you know, I can be having a bad day. I call Antonella and everything she's been through, she cheers me up. You're like, what is up with that? Like, that just puts it in perspective. So tomorrow night, Antonella, we're going to try to do a little bit more with you and I on video, just to hang out a little bit and talk to everybody before we offer the cross.
Yes.
But it'll be available at 8 p.m. tomorrow night. And they've told us how many they can make for us. It is going to be an advance order. Definitely look at that time window, because it's going to be an extended time window.
They like to take the holidays off.
But I do feel like that's kind of one of the nice things is, number one, there's always a great feeling about getting a beautiful piece of jewelry when you buy it, when you make the decision. So when you look at it, it makes you happy. When you buy it, it makes you happy. Knowing that you are doing something that helps someone out that you already adore makes you happy. And then looking forward to it until you get it makes you happy. And then getting it makes you happy. And then wearing it makes you happy.
So like,
all the good stuff. So I actually think the extended time window on this one is kind of just more of all the good stuff.
Yep.
So Antonella, thank you so much, honey.
We'll
talk tomorrow night.
Oh, thank you, you guys. I love you.
We love you.
Bye.
Bye.
All right, so Antonella, who we adore more than life itself. And I know that, you know, David adores her. He's worked with her for years.
Oh my gosh.
I adore her. I've worked with her for years. You know, we're talking about people who have spent a lot of time with her, who know her very, very well. And just what you see is what you get. When it comes to Antonella, what you see is what you get.
Yeah, that's true.
I could not think more highly of her. So I want to remind you that tonight at 8 p.m., we're going to have a beautiful, beautiful ring.
Yes.
We have more beautiful jewelry coming up tomorrow. We're going to have that beautiful necklace for Antonella on tomorrow evening and hopefully talk to her before we offer that. And I do hope that everyone is having a wonderful, wonderful holiday. Whatever you celebrate, I hope it is the best one ever. I hope you get to spend it with people that you love and eat lots of things you love to eat and laugh a lot and have a wonderful, absolutely wonderful day.
Bye, everyone.
So, Merry Christmas.
Merry
Happy
Christmas.
Holidays. Bye.